morning, children. Children, as we have gone through yesterday about the terms of credit and two sectors of credit, that was formal sector of credit and informal sector of credit. So today we have started the last topic of this chapter, that is self-help book. Here, children, we need to understand self-help book means to help yourself. Means the people are sitting together, they are making a union and they are collecting on, you know, pooling their savings to help each other, to help their members. Fine, so in this topic, we will be able to understand how the self-help group function in rural areas at a very grassroots level, why they are starting their self-help groups or unions in villages. Fine. So first of all, take a look. What do you mean by the self-help group? Children, self-help group means the people in rural areas are helping each other at a very basic level to meet their requirements. This is actually because bank is not available everywhere. Children, we know that the bank follows a kind of terms and condition, right? Collateral process. The borrowers must have the collateral or the documents, and in the absence of that, people are moving in the informal sector of credit, fine, and ultimately they trap into debt, fine. So different way, in a recent years, people generally, they are making their own unions, which actually provides the help by providing the loan facilities at a very small level, fine, to meet their requirements, fine. So generally, bank facilities is not available everywhere. So these type of self-help groups are found in remote areas of village or rural areas, jahan pe hilly areas or bahut far away places hai, wahan pe self-help groups hote hain. Theek hai, generally 15 to 20 members make their unions, or it depends, usse zyada bhi ho sakta hai. Then third important feature, all the members of the self-help group actually pooling or collecting their savings on up to 25 rupees to 20 or up to 100 rupees, means whatever their capability to save or to give, right? And then they also charge very small rate of interest, right? So in this way, they are providing small amount of loan to their members to meet their requirements, like for the purchasing of seeds, fertilizers, and whatever raw materials they required for their production, right? For example, in the rural areas, generally women need some help to establish or to do something to establish their living or to make their firms, like they make small scale industries. They need sewing machines and some other device or any other thing, inputs, okay, for establishment. So they require the raw materials to make their production. Similarly, the self-help groups provide the loan facilities at a very small scale to help each other. As the name suggests, jaise ki naam se pata chalta hai, self-help group means it is basically established for helping each other. Fine, children, we can see here the people, in the absence of collateral or documentation, they generally, moving towards such type of facilities. Jahan pe unko lenders, money lenders, jo ki high rate of interest charge karte hain, theek hai, usse better option unko ye laga ki self-help group bana ke wo ek dusre ki help kar sakte hain. Okay, we can see here in this page, self-help group includes 15 to 20 members. They pool their savings up to 25 rupees to 100 rupees, and they mutually sit together as per their capability and the requirement. They make their loans and provide loans to their members. Fine. And these are the requirements. For example, they want to acquire some assets, raw material, clothes, sewing machine, cattle, seeds, etc. Fine. So this is a better, उनको ऐसा लगता है कि money lender से या informal sources of credit से better option self-help हो सकता है, जहाँ से कि उनको loan मिल सकता है, right? सो फाइनली जो लोग ये लोन लेते हैं उसके लिए भी उन्होंने एक प्रोसेस फॉलो किया है। ऐसे सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स को आजकल बैंक भी हेल्प कर रही है, बैंक भी ऐसे सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप यूनियंस को लोन सैंक्शन करती है, प्रोवाइड करती है, ठीक है। और एंड दोज हु आर अनेबल टू रीपे द लोन उनके लिए सीरियस स्टेप्स भी जो है वो सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप के मेंबर्स सीरियस स्टेप्स लेते हैं, ठीक है। Because why people used to take the loans from self-help group because they do not require any kind of collateral or documents. ठीक है, कोई collateral या documents की जरूरत नहीं है. That is why they are making the union and providing small scale loan facility. Right? So what is the outcome? What is the final outcome of such self-help groups? We can see here generally the borrowers taking the small loan. जिसमें कि रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट बहुत कम होता है, जिससे उनको रीपे करना बहुत ही आसान होता है, ठीक है, वो आसानी से पे कर सकते हैं। लेकिन फुलफिल देयर रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑन टाइम, अपनी रिक्वायरमेंट्स को टाइमली फुलफिल कर सकते हैं, ठीक है। एंड अनदर थिंग इज जनरली दे ये जो सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप है वो वुमेन्स फॉर्म कर रही हैं, जहाँ पे कि दे आर गेटिंग अ प्लेटफॉर्म टू डिस्कस देयर सोशल इश्यूज, देयर फाइनेंशियल प्रॉब्लम्स, right, health issues, they can sit together and they discuss about their daily problems at a very basic level, and in this way they are helping and becoming self-reliant, and this is very important. They are working as an organized way. Fine. So one example is given here, a women self-help group meeting in Gujarat, and you can see in this picture it is given. The people are sitting together, they are discussing their problem and try to help each other by resolving the issues. I hope this is clear to you all, fine. And what we can sum up here, in this chapter we have learned about the money, what are the functions of the money. Money is used to medium of exchange. We can easily purchase things or goods and services, whatever we want we can easily give the money and take the good. Similarly, whatever we want to sell we can sell the good for the money, fine. So our transactions become very simple and convenient after the invention of money. That is the most important function. Then we have learned about the forms, different forms of money, modern forms of money, that is check, demand deposits, currency, paper notes, coins, okay. And another one is DD, that is demand deposits, that we have gone through, fine. And we have also learned the formal and informal sector of credit. Formal, that is supervised by the centralized bank, that is Reserve Bank of India, and informal sector, no such organization is supervising them, so that is why they are autonomous body. They are generally harass the borrowers, that we have gone through in this chapter. And because of such discrimination, because of such exploitation in the informal sector, people are moving towards the in the rural areas self-help group. They are creating their own union or cooperation, okay, to help each other, fine. So I hope this topic is clear, children, to you all. Please go through the chapter and we will do the question answers in our next session. If you have any problem, you can ask